welcome to all students for design of machine tool gearbox. Today we discuss about structural diagram. It is very important part of structural diagram. This is the some calculation of structural diagram. Today we discuss about how to draw this structural diagram. This is the structural diagram. In structural diagram, there is kinematic diagram of gearbox, also is called as gearing diagram. After deciding the range ratio, geometric progression ratio, the number of speed steps and the number of transmission groups, it is necessary to construct the kinematic diagram or gearing diagram of the gearbox. These would include determine the following: to determine the number of shaft in gearbox, to determine the number of gears on each shaft, to determine the layout of arrangement of the gears, to determine the number of teeth on each gears. So this is the gearing diagram basic requirement. For constructing the kinematic diagram of the gearbox, it is required to know the distribution of speeds on input shaft, intermediate shafts and output shaft. For this purpose of the following parameters are important, like structural formula, structure diagram, ray diagram and speed diagram. In structure formula, it is the mathematical expressions giving the number of speed steps in each stage and the number of spindle speed steps by which two adjacent speed values of each stage are separated. As it is already discussed that multiple speed can be obtained by Z is equal to P1 into P2 into P3 into Pn. So in some cases it is not possible to have equal values of P. For example, consider a case where there is a three transmission stage. Hence the above equation become Z is equal to P1 into P2 into P3. So we can calculate Z. So where Q is equal to number of stages where transmissions are equal, Z is the number of combinations given. So this is very important part. Now in more expressions for total number of spindle speeds can be written as Z is equal to P1 X1 P2 X2 dot dot Pn Xn. The above equation is called as structure formula for multi-spindle gear box. The values of X1, X2, X3, like X1 is equal to 1, X2 is equal to P1, X3 is equal to P1 into P2, Xn is equal to P1 into P2 into Pn minus 1. So for considering 12 speed gearbox, Z is equal to 12, so N is equal to 12, so Z is equal to 12, so 2 raised to N1 into 3 raised to N2, so N is equal to 3. The number of stages where the transmissions are equal, Q is equal to so. So these are the important for the structure diagram. There are different types of structure diagram. The structure formula which describe the kinematic structure of the gearbox are represented in the form of special graphs called structural diagram. These diagrams are also called as Germer layouts after the name R. Germer who invented them. So I am repeat again what is structure diagram. The structural formulae which describe the kinematic structure of the gearbox are represented in the form of special graphs called as structure diagrams. For there are procedure for constructing structure diagram. First, draw N+1 number of vertical lines at a suitable distance from each other. The first vertical line represents the input shaft, whereas the last vertical line represents the output shaft. The remaining vertical lines represent the intermediate shafts, which form a transmission group or stage of the gear box. Draw Z number of horizontal lines at an internal of log 10 pi. Each horizontal line represents a spindle speed. The reason for equal distance between the horizontal lines is follow. Where let N1 is equal to minimum spindle speed in RPM. Also, these are the structure diagram. There are some features of structure diagrams. By drawing the structure diagram, The designer can imagine the flow of transmission in the gearbox, and it provides the features like the number of shafts in the gearbox, the number of gears on each shaft, the order of changing transmissions at each stage to get required spindle speed, the transmission range and the characteristic of each transmission group. The gear with making of two-way arrow are sliding gears, and the remaining gears are non-sliding types. There are some law of structure diagram. So there is each the drawn structure diagram for particular structure formula should be satisfied the following laws. Each line must connect another follow-up line till the final output shaft is reached. At any stage, the arrow must end at one point only. Two arrows should not end at one point, but at any input there can be more than one arrow. Generally, it is limited up to three. None of the arrows should go beyond the boundaries of the speeds at the output. On the output shaft, all the points must be connected by the arrows. So, arrows for particular gearing must be drawn parallel when repeated for another set in the same stage. At output shaft, the arrow must terminate at the intersection and not in between the horizontal lines. But at all other shafts, arrow can start and end at the intermediate points. There are types of structure diagram like open type and cross types. Like in open type, the structure diagram has no crossing lines, then it is called as open type structure diagram. If cross type, the structure diagram has lines crossing each other, then it is called as cross type structure diagram. There are some guidelines for best structure formula like I max is equal to N2 upon NIN less than equal to 2. I minimum is equal to N1 upon NIN greater than equal to 0.25. I max upon I min equal to 8. I max into I minimum equal to 1. The torque transmitted by shaft is given by T directly proportional to 1 by N from the strength consideration. For least radial dimensions of gearbox, number of gears on last shaft should be minimum. This is the deviation diagram of this gearbox. This is the speed gear box. In next lecture, we discuss about how to draw the speed diagram. So, in this lecture, we clear that how to draw the structure diagram.